first tiny home in the backyard in Windsor, Ontario. Yes, this is that tiny home. The first one got approved by the Windsor City. In this video, I'm gonna go over full details. Also, I'm here with Clarke, who will give you a full details if you wanna build one. Thank you, Clarke, for giving your time to go over this project.
No problem.
First of all, for who doesn't know you, who are you?
Yeah, so my name is Clarke Gallie. I'm an investment realtor with the Wind City team, best team here in Windsor. I'm also a investor myself. I own properties as well as developing Windsor's first tiny home, as we're standing in right now.
Tiny home guy.
Some call me.
That's a Windsor star called you.
Yeah. No, I didn't realize this was the first tiny home being built in Windsor.
Yeah, man.
I found out when I read the article.
To be honest. I have so many questions to ask you about the tiny home, but a little bit, why have you started this tiny home at the first place?
Yeah, so I also used to be, in a past life, a property manager. Mm-hmm. Used to manage about 60 to 80 units. And, I worked with a lot of investors here in Windsor. And what a lot of investors don't count for, in my opinion, is mm-hmm. capital expenditures and maintenance.
Yeah.
Those costs will kind of creep up over time. Like, for example, for this property, I had to spend $7,000 on a furnace about 2 weeks ago. And did I budget that in? I budgeted in some capital expenditures, but that $7,000, maybe AC, maybe the walls coming in a bit of a leak, that stuff happens and you don't really, recognize the cost until it happens. Whereas you build brand new, that cost can get deferred, 7-10 years sometimes, because from the ground up, you're building everything brand new and those costs will not hit you like previous investment properties.
I love that. That's so true, because, with the used properties that mm-hmm. are 50 years old, 100 years old, obviously will have expenditure. But why tiny home? Because you could have built something, in a lot.
Yeah. So why tiny home? Great question. We originally, my partner and I, we do this together, and we wanted to do construction. We recognized that, capital expenditures maintenance was too high. We wanted to do new construction. Mm-hmm. But getting a brand new lot and, development service, development fees, tapping into sewer systems, there's a lot of costs that goes into developing a new home on a new lot.
Yeah.
But if you're building in your own backyard, you can tie into existing services for probably about $2,000 to $5,000.
Yeah.
You don't have any development fees for a brand new home. Your development fees are probably under $5,000 for all the permits, and the land is free.
Yeah.
So if you're looking at another new lot, base cost, land plus $50,000 in those fees, or building your own backyard where the land is free and maybe $5,000-$7,000 in total for those fees. So you're saving in massive amounts of costs just from building your own backyard.
Yeah, that's so true. I don't know why no one ever built something like that.
Me neither.
Because when you think about it, right? That's so true. If I wanna, first of all, buy a new lot mm-hmm. in Windsor, nowhere you can get something that is serviced less than 100,000.
Exactly.
So now you have a house. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit more about how much you purchased this house and with the backyard lot.
Yeah, sir. Open book here. So we purchased the property for $220,000.
Okay.
The current tenants were paying $1,500 plus utilities. So we assumed the tenants.
Yeah.
Sort of off the bat, we're cash flowing maybe like $500-$600 a month.
Okay.
Which is pretty solid for, a single family home investment property. As well as the lot is actually 180 or 186 feet of depth.
Wow.
backing onto an alley. So we purchased this property in mind for building a tiny home in the back. We wanted to purchase a property where, it already cash flowed. So mm-hmm. every single month that we weren't building, it's not like, we were losing money.
Yeah.
So we were making money while still practicing and, experimenting in the backyard here.
Yeah, that's really good, because now if you buy a normal lot, you have to just sit with no money.
Insurance, taxes.
Yeah, exactly.
Payments. Yeah.
Now you're paying all your expenses from your rent and you're putting some extra money into your pocket.
Into this development.
There you go. Love that. So, can you, if you don't mind, can you run down how much are you expecting this construction cost going to be for you?
Yeah, so construction cost, it's obviously going to be a big experiment for the first property.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so we have estimates, but, maybe we can do a follow-up questionnaire once it's actually
built. Once it's done, yeah. But what's the estimate looks like?
Yeah, so estimated cost, we're hoping to build it, from ground up, start to finish, put a tenant in here for under $150,000. So this is a brand new property we're hoping to build for under $150,000. And
wow.
The rents we're hoping to put in here is about 1,000 to maybe 1,300 is estimates we've gotten.
So pretty much it's going to be almost like 1% rule.
We're trying to hit the
for new construction rule. House.
For a new construction house. And yeah, you wouldn't be able to, again, going back to, you know, if you want to build on a vacant lot versus your backyard, the cost alone on just this property would probably be an extra like 50, 60,000.
So that means pretty much you have a duplex.
A nice duplex,
less than 400,000.
Yes.
Wow, that's insane.
And it's interesting too, because you know, I've spoken with, you know, obviously, you know, we work with a lot of investors, house hacking, BRRRRs, we deal with all that. And you know, the one interesting thing about house hacking is people, you know, they want to, you know, it seems good in theory, you know, getting a duplex, living in one side, but you're still side by side to your tenant.
Yeah.
With this, it is a separate building. It is a separate backyard, separate parking. It's almost like two separate houses.
Yeah.
But you still get that house hacking, you know, guarantee of cash.
Yeah, I love that. So another big challenge, you know, big question that many who might think of this tiny home is, can I get funding? Can I get mortgage for the construction?
Right.
What's your take on that?
So, you know, it's really interesting. We're trying to figure out, you know, exactly how we're going to go about financing for the next few properties. But for this property right now, like obviously, you know, I got a mortgage when I purchased this property.
Yeah.
Investment property, you know, I put 20% down. Mm-hmm. And I went to the bank and we're actually doing something where it's a type of construction loan where it's in phases. So we went to them and we say, hey, you know, this is what we're building. This is the phases of the process of the construction that's actually taking place here. So kind of in line with the city inspections, the city inspections, you know, come out and say, okay, footing's in place, check. We take that, send it to the mortgage broker, and they go like, okay, you finished phase one of foundation. Here is your first $20,000-$25,000. So we have to pay it up front, and then right away we get that money back.
Got
then you go on to phase two and then phase three. We're looking at different options around, you know, different kind of construction loans. Mm-hmm. But that's the one we're doing for this property. That's how we're financing this one.
Oh, okay.
In the future, you know, there might be more interesting financing methods.
How much is the interest they're going to charge you?
It won't, you're just going to charge, like, I think it's a low three, high twos. Yeah, it's not dipping into commercial rates, but it's a little higher than residential rates.
Yeah, I mean, 3%, low 3% is pretty much like, you know, a lot of my properties that I purchased a year ago have that rate.
I was going to say, if you purchase your property now, you're like, 3%, what the heck? Yeah. But ask your parents, 3%.
They say 14%, right?
Yeah.
Man, that's awesome. So, pretty much with this you know, tiny home now you have in your backyard, how is the, you know, city reacted to this tiny home when you like initially started the process?
So with this tiny home too, we wanted to work with an architect that, you know, it wasn't just, you know, the average run of the mill. Like, we didn't want to be priced. We overpaid for the architect just because we wanted, you know, design to be on point. We wanted no issues with the city. The permitting process was delightful. You know, we brought in, you know, our drawings and they were like, oh, this is the architect using? Okay, no, this is probably good. You know, they didn't give it a second eye. Obviously, you know, they went over it, but, you know, they had much more confidence in us and our build because of the team that we surrounded ourselves with.
You hired the right person.
Hire the right person, get yourself in the right network, Win City team.
Yeah, there you go.
You get the right people around you in the city. You know, they recognize you're working with great people.
Yeah.
So, and, you know, they're ecstatic because they put this bylaw into action probably about 2018. And it took 2 years for someone to come forward and actually build it. There was about four or five other people that were trying to work with it, you know, trying to work with the bylaws, get in the right, you know, match the right bylaws and, you know, site specifications.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a little challenging. There is, you know, quite a bit, you know, that goes into actually having a site that's ready for this.
Yeah.
You know, we checked all the boxes. We didn't have a single variance. We didn't have a single site, you know, variance going on for the property.
Yeah.
So we matched every single thing the city was looking for. We had a great team around us. So the city basically, you know, took our application. 2 months later, issued us a permit.
Wow. So it took just 2 months to get the permits?
A month and a half to 2 months.
That's it?
Yes.
Wow. And how long do you think you're going to finish this project, like construction?
So we have an estimate. I mean, obviously, you can say we're kind of already started the project. We're hoping to finish it in under 60 days.
Under 60 days. Wow. So pretty much like you can finish this project within like 60 days for construction and then 2 months for permits. So pretty much like less than 4 months you can have a
4 months if you have a site that you're thinking about getting a tiny home on. If you put the time and effort into it, you could essentially have a tiny home built and rented out within 4 months.
Yeah, that's insane, man. That's because how come other people didn't look into this, right? Like even though like they have started 2018, mm-hmm. why does it took city to give the first approval?
See, it's interesting because we've, you know, obviously going through this, I've talked to a lot of developers, a lot of construction guys in the city, and something like this, developers just don't want to look at. I mean, you know, this is my first development, so I'm still, you know, kind of learning the ropes here. But yeah, a lot of developers don't look at places under maybe like 1,500 square feet just because they're building, you know, multi-million or $500,000 homes out in Southwood Lakes,
yeah.
out in Tecumseh, LaSalle. You know, it's a lot of these bigger homes, so they can, you know, their margins are a lot greater.
Yeah.
You know, this build, like I said, we're trying to do it for under 150K. A lot of developers, it's just not worth their time.
Yeah, that makes
so
sense.
Anyone that wants to do it, they have to have enough knowledge and experience to almost, you know, run the trades and run the show themselves. I personally, I think that's why they haven't run forward with us.
Yeah, I love that. You know, that's true. It's like not a project that a big guy can take.
Exactly.
But at the same time, like not too small to like anyone can take it. It's, you need mm-hmm. some skills. So what's your future plans look like with this tiny homes?
Tiny homes are awesome. We're looking to, you know, we have a set goal, my partner and I, of looking mm-hmm. to build 5 tiny homes in 2020.
Wow.
We secured the land for the next 2. Mm-hmm. We're working on securing the land for number, I guess, 4 and 5.
For what?
Mm-hmm. So we're hoping to build, you know, 5 this year. We've gotten, you know, since the article came out, we've gotten a lot of requests. They're like, hey, can you build on my land? Hey, I got land in Amherstburg. Hey, I got land in Windsor. Can you quote tiny homes? So we have a lot of service requests. I've been quoting some tiny homes out and seeing if it works.
So probably now you're going to get more requests because now viewers need more information.
Yeah, no, because it's not easy. You know, the site... you really have to kind of dive into the site-specific location,
yeah.
even the area of Windsor. You know, there's a lot of, the zoning has to come into play, the setbacks, there's a lot of kind of specific yeah. stuff that has to go into it. So it really depends on, you know, the lot size, and then there's a lot of steps you have to go through.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, no, the goal right now is building 5 this year, and then 2021, open book at this point.
Oh, that's awesome, man. I'm pretty sure you're going to make it. So if someone have any questions, what's the right spot to hit you?
Yeah, you know, I'm available on, you know, Facebook, Instagram. You can see me on the Wind City website.
Yep, I'm going to put it in the description, all the links.
We have our own nccapital.ca is also our website where we kind of post updates on the build, kind of what's going on with our company there.
Sure, I'm going to put that link as well.
If you just one step ahead of me. That's pretty much we kind of follow the process and what we're doing here.
Man, awesome. I'm really excited for this project because, you know, it's such a fantastic idea, especially for someone already own a home. Mm-hmm. If their backyard qualifies for building another extra, you're pretty much making 1% rule close to with a new build.
But that's the thing. Capital expenditures and maintenance, like that is going to be, out of any property you own, this will be the lowest capital expenditures and maintenance yeah. costs for the next 7 to 10 years out of any of your properties.
Exactly, because pretty much now you don't have any capital expenditures for next 7 to 10 years. Right?
Nope.
I would say like not even 7 to 10 years, probably like 20 years.
I'm a bit conservative, but...
Yeah, I mean, yeah, being too conservative, but generally, you know, roof, furnace, AC, mm-hmm. all these mechanicals will last for 15, 20 years.
Exactly.
You know, just God forbid, but still like 10 years is like... You're just sitting on a cash flow property for 10 years. Even if you want to sell, at least your mortgage paid down.
Mm-hmm.
Even there is no appreciation. So it's really such a unique model. I'm pretty sure many people can take advantage of the bylaw that we have, you know, the demand we have. Man, thank you so much. It's a great information. Even I learned so many things because I've been interested in this project for a while. So is there any suggestions that would you give for someone who is looking to do something like this?
If you're looking to do something like this, you know, I'd be more than happy to, you know, reach out to me. I can do a quick, you know, site analysis, you know, from Google Earth and kind of other software I have and the city has as well, and kind of do a quick analysis to see if your property is eligible for a tiny home and the size you're able to build it to. And then, you know, if your property is actually available for a tiny home, you know, we can take another step further and kind of more look into more costs and kind of yep. stuff that way. But the first initial thing is, can your property legally have a tiny home in the back? And that'll, you know, kind of set you apart from if you want to do next steps or not.
Yeah, and also another good thing is if you're looking to buy the property, which, you know, you want to put a tiny home now, Clarke is also a realtor, so he can help you find the property which has a potential. So reach out to him for any questions. Clarke, thank you so much for your time, man.
Thank you.
Good luck with your future projects.
I hope we do a follow-up interview once.
Of course, we're going to do that. So stay tuned for future videos.
Awesome.